And welcome back to my channel. Okay, so in today's video I thought I would film a huge Feel Unique haul. I of course, as usual, was up late last night. Actually, it wasn't last night, it was the night before, and I was online shopping as usual, and I needed to get some top-ups of my makeup, and I thought, you know what, I may as well film a haul. I don't know where the top-ups and the haul came from, but hey ho. So yeah, I'm really excited. There is a lot of drugstore makeup, a couple of high-end bits, a couple of my top-ups, which I needed. I also got some drugstore like skincare and things like that. So yeah, I'm really excited to film this haul. I was gonna film a haul slash doing my makeup, but then I thought, you know what, I spent like £340 or something ridiculous. I don't know what, like, this is why someone needs to take my phone away from me in the evenings, because I just shop and I don't know, like, it's like I have no control. I don't get it. So yeah, I did some damage, but I really hope you guys enjoy it. So yeah, I thought I could film this video as like a haul, and then my next video I can film a makeup tutorial using all of these bits, mainly the drugstore bits, which I'm really excited to share with you. And then I thought I could also film a drugstore skincare routine with the bits in here. So yeah, so if you'd like to see everything I picked up from Feel Unique, drugstore bits, a couple of high-end bits, a couple of my top-ups and skincare and things like that, then please keep watching. Okay, so the box came this morning. I haven't actually opened it yet, so I've got some scissors here and I thought we could open it together, because I've never done an order this big with Feel Unique before. Okay, here is my receipt. Oh my god, like, look at this. Ready? Like, this just doesn't... What is this? Let's just put that down there, shall we? Ooh, okay. So, this is everything we've got. I'm going to pop it down there and then just pick things up and show you guys. I'll try and do it in orders so it sort of makes sense. But if you've never shopped with Feel Unique before, they're really good. They literally sell everything from drugstore to high-end to skincare bits and just loads of bits and bobs like that. And I feel like they're the most reliable shop when it comes to things being in stock, especially like the colours and things like that. So yeah, I'm really excited about it. I'm really pleased with everything that I picked out. So the first things I got, you guys know, I love a sheet mask. Literally, I wear them all the time. And the Garnier Moisture Bomb masks are my favourite. I literally have them in all the different sort of scents, would you say? I always get confused with this. It's like the different scents that they do. So this is a nighttime one. So you're meant to put it on, I think, just before you go to bed. And it's just meant to help you unwind and just get ready for a good night's sleep. So I got the mask. And then I also, I also got the Moisture Bomb eye mask, which I haven't had. It literally looks like this. So I guess I'm going to look like a mummy after I put all of these on. But I'm really excited about it. I feel like my eyes need a little bit of TLC at the moment. I feel like my sleeping pattern is a bit normal. I'm still waking up early, but some nights I have late nights shopping like this. So yeah, they're a little bit puffier and darker than usual. So I thought, oh, you know what? I need some like eye treatments. So I got this. I picked up another one of these. I use these all the time. When it comes to face masks, I'm so picky when it comes to my skin. Without sounding a bit like, oh, I use a lot of like good skincare products. My favourite brands are Elemis, Garnier and L'Oreal. They're like the three brands I go to when it comes to my skin. I know that I can rely on them and I feel like they're really good. So I love this mask. They have loads of different masks for different meanings. This one's my favourite. This is their Pure Clay Detox Mask. And it's got charcoal in it and it's just so good. It's whenever I put it on, I feel like if I have any like blemishes or anything like that, you can just see it like pulling it out. It sounds gross, but it's just amazing. I made Bradley do it with me the other day and his skin looks so good after. So yeah, honestly, this is such a good mask. So top ups of this are always needed. So I also picked up this range. This is the L'Oreal Paris Fine Flowers range. So I've got a cream wash, a toner, and then a milk, which removes removes and cleanses makeup off your face. Okay, so I thought these look really good. I, like I said, I use a lot of Elemis products and I know they're not the most affordable, so I thought it's a good idea to trial out some sort of more affordable products and let you guys know how I get on with them, and if they're any good I can film a dedicated like drugstore skincare video for you guys, and then you can try them out as well. So yeah, I thought all of these looked really nice, so I'm really hoping that they are really nice as well, and I think they look really cute together like a little set, you know what I mean, and the packaging is amazing, so I'm really excited to try these, and yeah, I'll keep you updated on how I get on. Okay, this is another product from L'Oreal. There's a lot of L'Oreal in here. I love L'Oreal. This is their Hydrogenious Aloe Water. I see this all over the internet. I've seen so many influencers using this, and it's in the same bottle as their True Match foundation, it looks like, but it's basically like a serum slash water that you put on your face before your makeup, and it's meant to just be amazing, like a drink of water for your face basically. So I'll film this in the next video that will be up on Sunday. So I'm trying to work out here because I'm pre-filming. So yeah, this video, the next video will be up on Sunday where I'm going to show you guys all of this makeup, bit of a first impressions, more of a drugstore makeup, and yeah, we can use this then, so I won't try it until then, and then you can get like a full first impressions of it then. How many times did I say then? The next product I got was this Garnier Natural Bronzer Self-Tan Mist. You guys know I'm obsessed with this. I love this one, and then the Saint-Tropez, I think it's a Purity Mist, I think that's what it's called. This one I feel like works quicker and it is a little bit darker. It's basically a fake tan spray that you spray on your face, and then I always do it before I go to bed, and then I wake up, I'm like, oh, I've been on holiday. But you've just been to bed basically. So yeah, it says results in an hour. I personally feel like it needs a little bit longer to develop, so yeah, I do it before bed and then I wake up and I'm all nice and bronzed. I feel like it takes about 2 days for it to like fully work, if that makes sense. So yeah, with this it's really good because you can sort of layer it over the top, so yeah, I love it. I always spray it and then I get like a cotton bud, and then I just go around my eyebrows so I don't get like orange eyebrows, because that's not what I want. So yeah, I always go around my eyebrows afterwards, and then yeah, I'm good to go. I've literally been needing this. If you watch my previous video, you will know I had such a pale face in the video that I was just like, oh, I didn't fake tan. I didn't have any fake tan the day before, so I was like, great. So now I've got some, which is amazing. So my next video, which will be a makeup tutorial, I promise I'll have a nice bronzed face because of this. Okay, so there is a lot of new Revolution makeup that I've seen all over the internet. I used to, like when I first started YouTube, I used to use a lot of Revolution makeup. I feel like that's the sort of makeup that I use that just inspired me to get into beauty and just to start a YouTube channel in the first place. I used to love getting affordable makeup that you could create so many different looks with. And I remember there was this one palette, and I think I've still got it, from Revolution, and I absolutely loved it. And from then, I just adored the brand. So I always like to trial out new products that they bring out because they're affordable, but they just like they just get better and better. It's just so good. So they've got a lot of skincare. This is their skincare lotion. I'm not even going to try and say this word, but it is a clarifying essence spray with chamomile extract. It's vegan, cruelty free, and I think it's just one of those refreshing skincare sprays. Slightly like a toner. I'm not sure if that's 100% correct, but that's personally what I use things like this for. I feel like skincare sprays are just so refreshing, honestly. I use them all the time. I use it in the morning before I go to bed. I actually have a skincare mist on the side of, whoopsie, on the side of my bedside table because I use it all the time, and it's just so refreshing on your skin. And it's sort of, when I feel a bit lazy and I'm like, oh, I can't be able to moisturize, I'll just spray the mist and I feel refreshed and hydrated, and yeah, it's just great. So I'll let you guys know how I got on with that because it looks really good. Oh my god, I completely forgot about this. So they had this like promotion on where you typed in this code. I forgot what the code is. If I remember, I will link it for you guys down below if it hasn't expired. And then you got a free gift worth over, was it over 60 or 100 pounds? It was something ridiculous because I spent over a certain amount. So I'm intrigued to see what's in here because I don't have a clue. Is this open? So the first thing is, ooh, an eye mask. I love an eye mask. What brand is this? Sarah Chapman. I've heard really good things about this brand, so I'm really excited about this. This eye mask looks great, especially for my needs at the moment because my eyes are just so puffy. So I'll let you guys know how I get on with this. Has all of these really cute products in. So this is from Elizabeth Arden. This is their anti-aging insensitive repair daily serum. Like a little tester thing there. Oh, David Beckham, a face moisturizer. I can give that to Bradley. Oh, I love Glam Glow. Glam Glow Gravity Mud Mask. This is so good. We've got a Kiehl's Powerful Strength Line Reducing Dark Circle Mask. Oh my God. This is what I need at the moment. You are, stay with me. Horez, is that how you say that brand? Never heard of it before. Nourishing Probiotic Gel Cream. Origins Cheek and Balances. What's this? Face Wash. We've got an Evelyn Rose Face Foam. A lot of skincare. I'm guessing this is just skincare. A serum. Oh, another Elizabeth Arden product. What's this? Skin Renewal Booster. I don't know why I said booster. Looks like that. Oh look, some little facial pads. CeraVe, I love this brand. Moisturising lotion. I feel like whenever I went to the doctors and I had a rash or something, I'd get this brand. I think that's it. What's this? Lift Structure. So that's really cute. I can't remember what the code was, but you just put in a code and you get this for free. So if I remember it, I'll pop it for you guys down below. But yeah, you do have to spend over a certain amount. I can't remember the exact amount, but that's so cute. And I like the little bag that it comes in. It's really cute. Okay, so I got a lot of Revolution makeup. I haven't tried any of their sort of new range and I was dying to try it. I need some scissors. Okay, so this is their Glow Primer. I feel like it's been used already. I feel like maybe you need to shake it a little bit. I think it's got scent. That does feel really nice and like shimmery. So yeah, again, I can use it with you guys next week. But the packaging is really lovely. I feel like it's really luxury. I feel like Revolution have upped their game. Correct me if I'm wrong, but is Revolution Pro the newer brand of Revolution where they have a little bit more pricier products but better quality? Is that right? Let me know in the comments. But yeah, this looks really good. I'm the worst at opening boxes. So this next product is a highlighter. Oh my goodness. So the packaging looks like this. So already amazing. Look at that. How beautiful is that? I don't want to swatch it because I want to take some pictures of it because it looks so cute. I can't get over this. Like, the quality feels so good. If someone put like a YSL sticker on it, I'd 100% believe that. That feels so nice and the quality is amazing. I love this rose that's printed on it. Oh my God, I'm so excited to use that for that video. So yeah, that's their Luster Highlighter in the shade Golden Rose. This is the Revolution CC Perfecting Pressed Powder. It's the same sort of similar vibe, but this one has got sort of snake print on it, as you can see. And then the powder looks like this. How cool is that? I love how all of them have got like a different pattern. So that's really cute. I got that in the shade Warm Maple, which looks a little bit pinky if I'm honest, but we'll make it work. Okay, so the next product is this Revolution Highlighting Potion. So this honestly looks so nice. What's the consistency like? Okay, it's a bit lighter than I thought. I thought I was gonna get the darker one, which is fine. But it is really beautiful. It's more of like a dewy highlighter. I love the iconic London highlighter. I've got it on at the moment. I literally wear it every single day. So when I saw this, I was like, oh my God, because this is obviously so affordable. And it looks really lovely. So yeah, it looks like this. The quality is insane. I got it in the shade gold. I think I would go a shade darker next time. But it actually blends out so nicely, like seamless. So yeah, I really like it. I'm excited to actually properly try this. And I think it looks so expensive, don't you think? So good. So the next product I got was this. This is the Maybelline Superstay 24 Hours Full Coverage Foundation. I've heard really good things about it. I'm hoping this shade is okay. There was only two shades left, which I was sad about. It looks a little bit pinky, but I'm hoping we can make it work. I feel like it's got the right sort of tones, but it's slightly pinky, but I don't know. Hopefully it will look really nice on, but I've heard really good things about it and I've never tried it before. So yeah, if you've tried this, let me know your thoughts on it. What is the foundation in comparison to like a higher end one? I've heard it's sort of like the, I forgot what the foundation's called. Is it Elizabeth Arden or, I can't remember. But yeah, it's meant to be really good. So I got this in the shade, where does it say the shade? Oh, 32 Golden. The next thing I picked up was this Revolution New Neutral Eyeshadow Palette. It's in the style or shade I think it's just new neutral. I thought there was like a technical term. So oh my god, this is so lovely. So this is what the palette looks like. I feel like it is definitely a dupe for the Huda Beauty new nude palette, which you guys know I love, and I always like to try and find like affordable alternatives for it. So yeah, I really like it. I like the packaging. It's just simple, isn't it? So yeah, I really like this. I'm excited to use it and hopefully it is really good. Oh, I'm really excited to try this. So this is the Revolution 5% Caffeine Solution Hyaluronic Acid. It's for under eye serum. You can tell that night I was like, I need these under eyes to go. So it's basically meant to help with them, and the fact that it's got caffeine in it is incredible because caffeine wakes you up, makes you feel so much better, I personally think. So yeah, the fact that this is an eye drop is just incredible. So yeah, I'm really excited to use it. There's a little pipette it comes with. So yeah, I'll let you guys know how I get on. I can add this in my drugstore skincare routine, but I'm gonna try this a lot beforehand, especially just so I know it's good. So yeah, hopefully it works. The next product I got was this e.l.f. blush. It's in the shade Berry Merry, not Mary Berry, Berry Merry. How do you open this? That was hard to open. And it looks like this. I'm not gonna lie, I thought it was gonna be a little bit darker, maybe the more you use it. It does look really cute and just like pinky and pretty. So yeah, I really like e.l.f. makeup. I kind of want to do like a dedicated video just to e.l.f. makeup. What do you guys think? I used to use them all the time. So yeah, this packaging is just really hard to open. Honestly, it's like you put all your muscles into it. But yeah, the shade of this looks really lovely. So I'm excited to use it for my next video, and then you guys can see how I got on with it then. So yeah. So the next product is Beauty Blenders. These are the Real Technique ones, and these are the original Beauty Blenders, I think, like Real Techniques came up with them. I'm sure that's it, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's what I thought anyway. I might be totally wrong. See, I've never actually tried these ones before. My one right now is literally breaking apart. I think I got it from Sigma, and it's just breaking. It's on its last legs. So I thought, you know what, I'll get some more. And yeah, these weren't actually that bad. I think they were like either £5 or £7. I feel like somewhere in that bracket. So yeah. Oh, I picked up a Revolution Pro Ultimate Coverage Crease Proof Concealer. Crease proof. That's where I was like, right, you're getting in my basket. So yeah, I hate when I use certain concealers, I get really bad creases under my eyes. No matter what powder I use, if it's an insane powder, it just doesn't get rid of it. So I'm really looking for new products like this. So hopefully this is really good. I got it in the shade C5. It looks like this. Yeah, it does look really lovely actually. The colour looks really good. And I like the... Oh, everything. I like the packaging because it's really easy just to squeeze out, and I don't know, I feel like it looks really cute and simple. I feel like all the Revolution Pro, all of the packaging looks unbelievable. Like, it looks really smart. Just really reminds me of the YSL packaging. So I'm really excited to try all of this makeup. Oh, I also got a black liner. This is going to take me years to open, so I'm not going to open this because that is like sealed. It's just like a felt tip liner. I got it in black, again from Revolution. This is, I always find with eyeliners, don't start off with like a liquid. I don't use liquid anymore. I prefer using like the pens. I feel like they're so much better. You have so much more like control over it. And yeah, I just feel like it's a really good thing to practice on. So I really like felt, it looks like a felt tip, but it's not, it's like a pen liner. I also picked up another powder. I love powders. I feel like that's like the product that seals in all my makeup as well as setting spray. And then I like to glow up with like actual highlighter and sort of glowy mists and stuff. So I picked up the L'Oreal Infallible 24-hour matte powder in the shade Sand Beige. A little bit pinky, it looks like. Maybe it's a tiny bit, but I feel like we can make this work as well. So yeah, I've had this before and I love it. So I picked up a L'Oreal concealer. This literally looks like the same colour as my background. I feel like this blends in perfectly. I didn't realise I got a white concealer. How am I even... That's actually white. I feel like I'm gonna have to get a new concealer. This is way too light for me, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like I'd look ill if I put this on under my eyes, so I'm not gonna use this. I feel like I'll give this to one of my sisters or one of my friends, see if they want it, because I didn't realise I got such a light colour. Do you ever do that? Look online and it looks so dark and the wrong colour comes and you're like, right. I feel like you guys are gonna be happy with me here. I picked up a lip liner from NYX. This is in the shade Natural. It's a bit more of like a pinky tone, so I thought I could use it in my next makeup tutorial and you guys can let me know your thoughts on it, because for years now I've literally used the Rimmel Cappuccino lip liner, literally all I use. And I love it. So yeah, hopefully this is really nice and it might be my new fave. So I'm really into like lip glosses at the moment, and I saw this one again from Revolution. I feel like their range, honestly, there was so much on there. I was like, yeah. This is a lip gloss which looks like this. Oh, I like the applicator. I've never seen one like this before. Oh my goodness, that looks so nice. So we can use that next week. I realised all my lip glosses are clear, which is a good thing because you can sort of tailor make a lip gloss to the colour that you're wearing. But at the same time, sometimes when you're out and about, you just want to pop it on. Out and about, I mean like going for my walk or something. Not like going to town or whatever. Lockdown hasn't lifted yet, but in that sense, you guys know what I mean. I really like that. Oh, I also picked up a microblading effect brow pencil, again from Revolution. I feel like the next video should just be Revolution, to be honest with you. So yeah, I saw this, it looked really good. I'm not gonna open it because it looks like one of those, I feel like I'm gonna be here forever. But yeah, if you watch my next video, you'll see me use this in action over there. So this looks so nice. I picked up a L'Oreal lipstick. Oh my goodness, this feels so nice. This is the colour Richie? In the shade No Doubt. Oh my goodness, how nice is that colour? This lipstick is beautiful. It feels so nice. It's like a matte effect, but it looks really nice. I love the two tones on it as well. It like matches my nail varnish perfectly. So yeah, I really like this. And it's a really, really pretty pinky nude, and it's not too pinky. I hate ones that are like so pinky that I'm like, no, I can't wear it. So I really like that. Okay, so I've got e.l.f. concealer saving me here. I've never tried this before, but it looked really good. This is a flawless concealer. Not much to say about concealer really, but hopefully this is good. Again, like always, I will let you guys know in my next video. The applicator looks really nice. Oh my god, this is like the most ideal shade. This is in the shade light beige. So yeah, honestly, that is really nice. So the next product I got was this. I'm really into like lip balms at the moment and just looking after my lips. I don't know why. I feel like during like the start of lockdown, my lips were so dry. So ever since then, I've been really like careful. And I saw this and I think it's insane. So it looks like a lipstick from Rimmel and it's actually a lip balm. But look at this. So it's really easy just to apply. You don't have to faff around with like a Vaseline pot or anything like that. Really easy to apply just like lipstick. And then you're good to go with putting your lip liner on and then your lipstick or lip gloss, whatever. So I just thought that's really good. Like, it just looks like lipstick. I don't know. I really like that. So that's in the shade 01 Clear. Okay, there's not loads of products left, I promise. I picked up the L'Oreal Volume Million Lash in the shade. Obviously, I picked black, but it's in the style So Couture. Oh, this looks really good. Like, this applicator. How good does that look? Oh, I'm really in need of a new mascara. I literally keep getting my old mascara and putting some like mist on it just to bring it back to life for a little bit. It will last for like 2 days and then it dies again. I'm like, no, come on. So yeah, this is very much needed at the moment. Okay, so I've got three higher end things. This is the Huda Beauty Banana Bread Easy Bake Loose Powder. I've actually had this before. They sent it to me in a PR package, but I felt too bad like asking them. Like, I don't know, I felt too bad being like, hey, can I have another setting powder? So I just bought one. But yeah, honestly, Banana Bread is the most perfect shade for me anywhere. I just love this so much. It's so good. And it's got like a sponge here. Can you see? Like, that's a sponge. But it's just so nice and it doesn't crease your makeup up. I hate using like baking powders that just look like you're cakey. Like, literally, like you've baked your face and then you look like a cake. So no, this is so good. So yeah, the Shade Banana Bread is amazing. I picked up another one of my NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation in the shade Barcelona. This is honestly so good. I feel like it's my favorite foundation ever, and I'd go that far to saying that it is honestly my favorite foundation, especially for like a higher end one. It's so good. It literally lasts ages. I've got the shade Barcelona and also Valencia. Valencia's a little bit darker, so I'm waiting to get a little bit more tanned. But yeah, for now, Barcelona is like my perfect shade. And honestly, it is so good. If you want that more fuller, flawless coverage foundation, get this, try it. You'll be hooked because it's just so good. The last product, which I kind of felt a little bit like, should I buy it? Shouldn't I buy it? It was in my basket, so I was like, I guess I'm buying it then. Is the Huda Beauty Mercury Retrograde Palette. Now, this was all over Instagram, and I got jealous. And I was like, okay, I need this. Oh my goodness. This is just so nice. Oh my god. Are you ready? I don't know if you're ready. Are you ready? Look at this palette. I'm not, like, how insane is this? I don't know why. When I saw it, I just instantly felt, like, inspired. I was like, I want to create this makeup look. I want to do this makeup look. And I haven't felt like that in a long time when it comes to makeup, because I'm boring when it comes to makeup. And I feel like we all know this. I basically do the same look. So I saw this and I was like, I just feel like I want to do so many different looks with this. I feel like it's the most versatile palette, but it's good for an everyday look. It's good if you want to do like fancy dress. It's good if you want to do like a dramatic look, like a pink look. Any, like, it's just insane. I'm literally obsessed. I love how the mirror's like this. It's really sturdy plastic packaging. I love how the mirror's huge as well, and you can just hold it like this. I'm just obsessed. It's the sort of palette that I don't want to use yet. I'm not going to swatch it. I'm going to wait because I want to take pictures and stuff with it, but I feel like we already know that this is going to be insane. So yeah, how pretty is this? I'm literally so excited to use it. So, my lovelies, sadly, but probably happily for you because I've been talking for ages, this is the end of the video. I really hope you guys have enjoyed it. Let me know what product was your favourite. Mine was definitely the Huda Beauty palette, the one thing that wasn't a drugstore. But I just think it's so beautiful. I just felt so inspired and just, I just wanted to create so many looks with it. So yeah, I'm really excited to have a play around with that. Make sure you come back my next video, because I am going to show you guys, well, I'm going to create a full face of makeup using all of these products that I've shown you guys today. So yeah, I'm so excited for that one to go up as well. And then I'm also going to upload a drugstore skincare routine and all that kind of stuff. Let me know in the comments down below what videos you want me to film for you guys. And also, quickly, if you'd like to shop my lashes from Amy Rose Cosmetics, then I'll pop a link for them in the description box down below as well. But yeah, I really hope you lovelies have enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you have, because it will help me so much, and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye.